Brothers and sisters, welcome to once again this Liturgy of the Word session. And today we celebrate the second weekday of Ordinary Times, Thursday. And so together as a body of Christ, let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people, and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. On their way back, as David was returning after killing the Philistine, the women came out to meet King Saul from all the towns of Israel, singing and dancing to the sound of tambourine and lyre, and cries of joy. And as they danced, the women sang, "Saul has killed his thousands, and David his tens of thousands." Saul was very angry. The incident was not to his liking. "They have given David the tens of thousands," he said, "but me only the thousands. He has all but the kingship now." And Saul turned a jealous eye on David from that day forward. Saul told Jonathan his son and all his servants of his intention to kill David. Now Jonathan, Saul's son, held David in great affection. And so Jonathan warned David, "My father Saul is looking for a way to kill you," he said. "So be on your guard tomorrow morning. Hide away in some secret place. Then I will go out and keep my father company in the fields where you are hiding, and will talk to my father about you. I will find out what the situation is and let you know." So Jonathan spoke well of David to Saul, his father. He said, "Let not the king sin against his servant David, for he has not sinned against you, and what he has done has been greatly to your advantage. He took his life in his hands when he killed the Philistine, and the Lord brought about a great victory for all Israel. You saw it yourself and rejoiced. Why then sin against innocent blood in killing David without cause?" Saul was impressed by Jonathan's words and took an oath, "As the Lord lives, I will not kill him." Jonathan called David and told him all these things. Then Jonathan brought him to Saul, and David attended on him as before. The Word of the Lord. In God I trust, I shall not fear. Have mercy on me, God. Men crush me. They fight me all day long and oppress me. My foes crush me all day long, for many fight proudly against me. In God I trust, I shall not fear. You have kept an account of my wanderings. You have kept a record of my tears. Are they not written in your book? Then my foes will be put to flight on the day that I call to you. In God I trust, I shall not fear. This I know, that God is on my side. In God whose word I praise, in the Lord whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not fear. What can mortal man do to me? In God I trust, I shall not fear. I am bound by the vows I have made you, O God, I will offer you praise, for you have rescued my soul from death. You kept my feet from stumbling, that I may walk in the presence of God and enjoy the light of the living. In God I trust, I shall not fear. Alleluia, alleluia. Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life. You have the message of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus withdrew with his disciples to the lakeside, and great crowds from Galilee followed him, from Judea, Jerusalem, Idumea, Transjordania, and the region of Tyre and Sidon. Great numbers who had heard of all he was doing came to him. And he asked his disciples to have a boat ready for him because of the crowd, to keep him from being crushed. For he had cured so many that all who were afflicted in any way were crowding forward to touch him. And the unclean spirits, whenever they saw him, would fall down before him and shout, "You are the Son of God." But he warned them strongly not to make him known. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, today's reflection is taken from the first reading. In the first reading, we hear of this human rivalry between Saul and David, and this is something common that we experience in our human relationships within the church, our office environment, and even the church communities. What makes us become envious of the other and not rejoice in the goodness that we see? A very challenging attitude for us. Saul, as God's anointed in the first reading, became envious of David's success and popularity as the women who welcomed them after the slaughter of Philistines sang and openly praised David of having a better track record than Saul. This led to Saul's devious plan to get rid of David, and he began to see David more and more as a rival and enemy. Just like any human beings, Saul too had his shortcomings. He was overly concerned as to what other people thought of him and not how God sees him, and being disobedient to God's command on some occasions. Whereas David was always rooted in God's presence and sought God's will in whatever he planned to do. Even though Saul schemed to kill David, but his son Jonathan, who had a deep friendship with David, became a mediator between his father and David, and this saved David's life. In another instance, in another part of scriptures, there was a plot made against Paul in the Acts of the Apostle by 40 zealous Jews who made an oath to ambush and kill Paul as he was brought before the council. But Paul's nephew, who overheard of this evil plot, then goes to inform Paul, and the news was relayed to the tribune, who then provides safety for Paul to be brought to Felix, the governor. This goes to show that in the midst of challenges and problems faced, the Lord puts mysterious people like angels to give us a helping hand, especially in those challenging and difficult moments in our lives. Because Saul was blinded by his anger, envy, and hatred towards David, he only saw David in a negative light. Being God's anointed does not mean anything. Just like Saul, when we do not strive constantly to connect intimately with the Lord in our lives, and this can cause us to become counter-witness in our identity as God's beloved and not able to bear good fruits in our lives. This is where we need to be constantly rooted in the person of Jesus, especially through personal prayer, scriptures, and the Eucharist, to allow Jesus as the divine healer to heal our brokenness and woundedness. and not give in to the negativity that can cause division, unhappiness, dissatisfaction within ourselves and those around us. Otherwise, we can continue to live in a destructive way and bring this negativity burdens wherever we go, even right into our graves. Here we need the Lord's healing touch and grace to rise above our fallen nature and so reflect our true identity as God's beloved in a gradual way. When we are able to see our inner beauty as God's beloved, then our hearts and eyes will be open to see the beauty and wonder of God, most of all in His imperfect, broken, and wounded people. We need to imitate Jonathan, son of Saul, who acted as a mediator between Saul and David and diffused the negative, toxic, and volatile situation between his father and his good friend David. As God's anointed, we need to become mediators of peace and reconciliation to the imperfect and broken people around us and help them to be mindful of the goodness within them. Let us strive with the power of the Holy Spirit to go beyond our human imperfections, negativity, and make a conscious effort to see the good wherever we are, and so live our lives in a positive and life-giving way as Christ's light for our families, colleagues, and church communities. Amen. We turn to God our Father, whom we call as Abba, and pray this wonderful prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives. Thanks be to God.